Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in this video we are going to demonstrate GitHub Action with Terraform. We are going to deploying infrastructure on Azure with help of GitHub Action and Terraform. GitHub Action is a feature from GitHub that provide a way to automate the build, testing and deployment of code by using workflow. You can understand GitHub Action has a continuous integration and continuous delivery pipeline, a product from GitHub. Let's start step by step demo to implement GitHub Action with Terraform. We require to complete few steps in Azure before configuring the workflow in GitHub Action. First, we are going to create a resource group. In this resource group, we are going to create a storage account to maintain TF state file. Let's create a resource group. Click on create. Select the subscriptions and give the resource group name. Go ahead and create it. Resource group has been created. Now create a storage account. Click on create. Select the subscriptions and select the resource group. Give the storage account name. Terraform code, it is available. We don't require any fancy stuff in this storage account. Go ahead and create it. Storage account has been created. Now we require to create a container in this storage account to store the Terraform state file. Click on container and create a new container and give the container name. Go ahead and create it. Container has been successfully created. Now we require to create a SPN or Azure Service Principal. Terraform is going to use this service principal to authenticate for deploying the resources on Azure platform. Go to home, click on Azure Active Directory, then click on app registration, then click on new registration and give the name of your SP service principal. Leave all default option and go ahead and registered. We required four option from service principal. One is client ID. So copy this client ID and save it in the notepad. Then we required a tenant ID. We also required to create a secret for this service principal. Create on secret and click on new client secret and click add, and this is your secret. Copy both secret ID and value. We also required one more information, subscription ID under which you are going to deploy the resources from Terraform. So click on subscriptions and get the subscription ID. Now we require to provide the access to newly created service principal on Azure subscriptions. click on subscriptions, then click on subscription name, and then click on I am, then click on add, then click on add role assignment. Select the appropriate role. For the demonstration purpose, I am selecting the contributor role, and search your SPN and then save it. You can check the access. Now you can see here my service principal has contributor role on this subscriptions. So we have completed all required things on Azure. Now we are going to configure GitHub Actions. We are going to create a new repository for GitHub Action. Click on repositories, then click on new. I am creating a public repository and add a readme file. Go ahead and create it. Repository has been created. You can see many options, and action is one of the options. GitHub provide a sample template for many popular service. For example, this is sample template for Terraform GitHub Action. This is sample file for Terraform GitHub Action. You can use it for your reference. I am going to create a blank GitHub Action workflow file. Click on cancel changes, then go to action and click on set up this workflow. Give the name of the file and remember the path. The file is getting created under workflows. We will go and look at each line about the file. Meantime, go ahead and commit it. Commit new file. File has been committed. This is a sample or blank template file for the action. Before writing the Terraform files and workflow files, let's configure the credentials for the Azure platform. Go to settings, then go to secrets. At this moment, we do not have any secrets. Go ahead and create a new repository secrets. Give the name of the secret. Create a secret for client ID. This is your client ID. And click on secret. Let's go ahead and create another secret. This is the secret. Create another one. This is a tenant ID. And last one is Azure subscription. Go ahead and add secret. All the required secret has been created. Now let's go ahead and create required Terraform files to implement Azure resources. This is Terraform code to deploy resources on Azure cloud. I am going to create
TF state file on Azure Storage. I am going to create a resource group with this Terraform file. I am passing some of the variables to create the resource group. I created a separate module for the resource group. Main.tf file under resource group is going to create the resource group with define variables. This is the output section of resource group. You can download this file from my GitHub account. Now we are going to create a GitHub action workflow files. First, we need to clone this repository. Now go ahead and clone the repository. Repository has been cloned. I opened this file in Visual Studio. Let's try to understand this file line by line. This is the name of the file. In this section, we are saying that GitHub action will be invoked push on main branch. It means that whenever you push any content on main branch, then this GitHub action will execute. Next one is job. All the action will be part of Terraform job. In this job, we are requesting to GitHub to provide a Ubuntu machine, and we are going to set up the environment variable for Terraform credentials. This is client ID that is coming from settings, secret, and this is the client ID. Next one is client secret. This is the client secret. Next one is subscription ID. That is also coming from here. And last one is tenant ID. That is also coming from here. This is the method to get value from GitHub secret. We define this as a dev environment. We are saying that we are going to use bash shell to execute all the below steps. In the first step, we are going to check out Git repository on Ubuntu machine, and this is community step or action. You can read more about checkout project on this location. In the next step, we are executing a Terraform format command, and we are referring this repository for the action. You can read more about this repository on this location, and we are running this action with these parameters. We are using Terraform version 0.14.8, and this is command to use, and this is our working directory where all Terraform files will be reside. In the next action, we are using Terraform init, and this action will create a Terraform state file on Azure platform. In this action, we are validating the Terraform file. It is going to validate syntax and format of all Terraform files under this folder. This is Terraform plan command. And finally, we are running the Terraform apply command. So this is the complete GitHub action workflow files. Let's go ahead and push this folder on GitHub repository along with Terraform files. Let's go ahead and save it. I am going to insert our Terraform files and commit in my local repository. Committing this changes. Now go ahead and push the changes. Repository has been pushed. Let's verify. Yes. Now go to action. Now you can see here GitHub action invoke. It is completed all the steps. It is running on Terraform plan, Terraform apply. The entire workflow is going to executed as soon as we push this repository. Now you can see here the entire workflow has been completed. Let's verify on Azure cloud. First, let's look at the TF state file. Terraform state file should be created under Terraform demo resource group, and under this storage account, let's go to containers, TF state file, and you can see here Terraform state file has been created. Let's verify the resource group created or not. Go ahead and refresh. Now you can see here GitHub action resource group has been created from GitHub action workflow. Let's create another storage account. I modified the Terraform file to create a storage account. Let's push the changes on GitHub. Changes has been pushed on GitHub account. You can see here GitHub action invoke. All steps are going to be executed. Storage account is getting created. Job has been completed. Let's verify the storage account on Azure portal. We created a storage account in this resource group. And this storage account has been created. So we have created couple of Azure resources by using Terraform and GitHub action workflow. So this is the complete demonstration how you can use GitHub action workflow and deploy the resources on any cloud by using Terraform, CloudFormation, ARM templates, etc. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.